गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू द इंग्लिश वर्ल्ड ऑफ आराध्य. माई सेल्फ रश्मिन सर इम्पार्टिंग द नॉलेज ऑफ इंग्लिश टू द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 9 टू 12 स्टैंडर्ड इन इंग्लिश मीडियम. स्टूडेंट्स, सो फार वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड योर टू लेसन्स फ्रॉम सप्लीमेंट्री एंड थ्री लेसन्स फ्रॉम योर फोन बिल. ओके, टुडे वी विल टेक वन मोर सप्लीमेंट्री लेसन. द टाइटल ऑफ द लेसन इज रंगास मैरिज, विच इज़ योर थर्ड लेसन. Okay, it is written by Masti Venkatesha Iyengar, but the narrator of this lesson is different. His name is Shyama. So when you write the answer, don't say that writer said that, writer said that. No, here narrator is different and the writer is different. So entire story is narrated by one character, that his name is Shyama. Okay, so here the writer takes us to a world of many years ago. Okay, about 60-70 years ago, when the people over here in India did not know English, and especially South Indian people, they used to just give importance to their own language only. So the writer in the initial stage only talks about firstly about his place. Hosahalli is the village where they used to stay, and he compares Hosahalli with Hosahalli is a place in Mysore. So he compares Mysore with Kari Gadabu. Now Kari Gadabu is nothing but sweet samosas. So he compares Mysore with Kari Gadabu, and he says that just it is like, yeah, as Mysore is to Bharatvarsha, this Kari Gadabu is to this particular place. Okay. So we will see all those comparison. Then he talks why Hosahalli is famous. Hosahalli is famous for two important things. One is the mangoes of Hosahalli are so sour that one cannot taste it. Okay, just can taste it. The author, narrator says that once he tried that, he took that mangoes his home, just made chutney of that. All of his family members ate, and next day all of them found suffering from cough. And second thing Hosahalli is famous is the village lake, village pond, where a particular type of creeper grows, which has so beautiful flowers that it is really an opportunity to watch them. It is a very thrilling experience to watch such flowers. Then he talks about the status of English at that time. He says that nowadays you find many people speaking English, but 10 years ago it was different thing. So he already takes us into the past. In the past, again, he takes us 10 years ago. 10 years ago, what was the status of English in that particular place, Hosahalli? Nobody knew English. Okay, village accountant's son was the first one to go to Bangalore for studies. And when he came back, all the people were eager to see him. And that son is no other than our Ranga. So I'll read out the lesson. You will come to know more about it through the lesson. Okay. Ranga's marriage. Masti Venkatesha Iyengar. Ranga, the accountant's son, is one of the rare breed among the village folk. Okay. Rare breed means unusual person, who has been to the city to pursue his studies. When he returns to his village from the city of Bangalore, the crowds just move around. His house to see whether he has changed or not, because the village people would be curious. His ideas about marriage are now quite different, or are they? So all those things we will come to know. When he comes back, all the people just are eager to see him. All the people want to know whether he has changed or not. Okay, so students, we will learn the lesson in detail. When you see this title, some of you may ask, Ranga's marriage? Why not Ranganath Viva or Ranganath Vijaya? Well, yes, I know I could have used some other mouth-filling one like Jagannath Vijaya or Girija Kalyana. Aise title mein de sakta tha, writer admits. But then, this is not about Jagannath's victory or Girija's wedding. So that's why I have given a simple title. Ranga's marriage. Bravo. It's about our own Ranga's marriage, and hence no fancy title. The pura lesson hamare Ranga ke marriage ke bare mein hai, and that's why I have not given any fancy title. Simple title, so that everybody can understand. ओके, होसाहली इज आवर विलेज, यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड ऑफ इट, नो, व्हाट अ पिटी, बट इट इज नॉट योर फॉल्ट, देर इज नो मेंशन ऑफ इट इन एनी ज्योग्राफी बुक. Those tribes in England writing in English probably do not know that such a place exists and so make no mention of it. Again, students, you remember this lesson is written in English and earlier the English writing was done by the people, English people. So on the map normally you will find what the states, their capitals and big cities. Such small villages you will not find in maps. So in maps, if you can't find it, those English people would not know such a place. And that's why we don't find the mention of this particular place, Hosahalli, in any book. But here, the writer is writing about that, so that's why he has taken the name over here. Okay, so he gives reason why you have not heard the name of this place earlier. Because no English writer has mentioned this. They are concerned only about the big cities. Okay. Our own people too forget about it. You know how it is. They are like a flock of sheep. हमारे खुद के ही लोग भूल जाते हैं ये जगह के बारे में, तो फिर बाहर वालों को हम क्या उम्मीद करेंगे. ओके, वन शिप वॉक्स इन टू अ पिट, द रेस्ट ब्लाइंडली फॉलो इट. तो हमारे लोग ऐसा करते हैं, हमारे लोग भी भूल जाते हैं, एक शिप कहीं गया, पूरे पीछे पूरा टोला गया, वैसा है. When both the tribes in England and our own geographers have not referred to it, you cannot expect the poor cartographer to remember to put it on the map. Can you? तो writer को सिर्फ mention करना है नाम जगह का, तो वो mention नहीं कर रहा है, बराबर. बाहर के English writer mention नहीं करते, हमारे खुद के writer भी mention नहीं कर रहे, तो cartographer means a person who makes map. So how can you expect a cartographer to show that particular place in the map? It is a very small place. It is a very small village. So ye log mention nahi karte, to cartographer se kya ummeed kar sakte hai ki wo ye mention kare. Okay. And so there is not even the shadow of our village on any map. Map to kahin dikhega nahi, uski parchhai bhi kahin nahi milegi, koi bhi map pe. Sorry, I started somewhere and then went off in another direction. So the narrator confirms that he is going to talk about Ranga's marriage and he is talking about something else. Okay. If the state of Mysore is to Bharatvarsha, what the sweet curry gadabu is to the festive meal. So state of Mysore has certain value in entire India. So without that, entire India looks incomplete. So similarly, here it is said that the festive meal will be incomplete without curry gadabu. So, जैसे मैसूर के बगैर भारत अधूरा लगता है, वैसे करी गडाबू के बगैर तो ये त्यौहार का जो खाना है वो अधूरा लगता है. एंड करी गडाबू, आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू व्हाट इज इट, इट इज स्वीट समोसास. ओके, सो देन होसाहली इज टू मैसूर स्टेट व्हाट द फीलिंग इज टू करी गडाबू. और अगर मैसूर के बगैर भारतवर्ष अधूरा लगता है तो हमारा होसाहली क्या है. होसाहली को, वो होसाहली जो अंदर स्वीट समोसे में भरी हुई फीलिंग है वो है, जो हम स्वीट समोसे के अंदर मावा भरते हैं वो मावा बोले हमारा गांव है. एंड करी गडाबू इज़ व्हाट, मैसूर इज कंपेयर्ड विथ मैसूर, एंड द फीलिंग इनसाइड इज कंपेयर्ड विथ होसाहली. अंडरस्टूड? सो दैट्स वे ही कंपेयर्स, द नरेटर कंपेयर्स ओवर हियर दिस वे. What I have said is absolutely true, believe me. I will not object to your questioning it, but I will stick to my opinion. If you want to object to this comparison, you can object. But narrator says that I will remain stuck to my opinion. कि जैसे मैसूर भारत के लिए है, वैसे करी गडाबू फेस्टिव मिल के लिए है. और करी गडाबू में जो मावा भरते हैं वो मावा हमारा गाँव है. Understood? Without that, Mysore also is incomplete. Okay. Then, I am not the only one who speaks glowingly of Hosali. So, narrator again confirms कि मैं अकेला ही नहीं हूँ जो Hosali के बारे में ऐसा अच्छा-अच्छा बोल रहा हूँ. There are many others who speak good about Hosali. Okay, glowingly about Hosali. We have a doctor in our place. His name is Gunda Bhatta. He agrees with me. He has been to quite a few places. No, not England. If anyone asks him whether he has been there, he says, no, Anaya. Anaya means the word used for an elderly person. It is like sir. Okay, elderly person ke liye istemal karte waisa word hai, Kannada mein. Okay, so no, Anaya. I have left that to you. England mein jane ka maine aapke upar choda hai. Main England nahi gaya hoon. Running around like a flea pestered dog is not for me. Gunnar Bhattas bolta hai. कि मक्खी से परेशान कुत्ते के जैसे भागना मेरे लिए नहीं है, वैसे आप भागो, बराबर. बिकॉज आई हैव सीन अ फ्यू प्लेसेस इन माय टाइम दो, एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट ही हैज सीन मैनी. तो उसने बहुत सारे प्लेसेस देखे हैं, बट देन ऑल्सो ही स्पीक्स ग्लोइंगली अबाउट होसाली, बराबर. तो नाउ व्हाई दे आर स्पीकिंग गुड अबाउट होसाली, द रीजन्स आर गिवन ओवर हियर. आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेंशन, वन इज व्हाट द मैंगोज विच आर वेरी सावर्स. And writer shares his own experience that he made chutney and all the family members ate. But then what happened? All of them got cough. And second is a creeper which is growing in that village pond. And its flowers are really nice to watch. Okay, anybody would like to take photographs with the in the background of those flowers. Okay, we have some mango trees in our village. Come visit us and I'll give you a raw mango from one of them. कोई भी मैंगो ट्री में से मैं तुम्हें एक मैंगो दूंगा, रॉ यानी कच्चा, बराबर. डू नॉट ईट इट, जस्ट टेक अ बाइट. उसको पूरा मत खाओ, सिर्फ एक बाइट लो. व्हाट इज दैट? व्हाई ही टॉक्स अबाउट ओनली बाइट, वन बाइट. एक बाइट लिया ना, वो आम तुम वहीं छोड़ दोगे, इतना खट्टा होता है. अंडरस्टूड? यू माइट टेक इट आउट, कि यार कितना खट्टा है, मुंह में से निकाल दोगे. बाइट लिया हुआ भी मुंह में से निकाल दोगे, ऐसा वो बोलता है. डू नॉट ईट इट, जस्ट टेक अ बाइट. The sourness is so sure, is sure to go straight to your Brahmarantra. That is what, that shows that it is extreme sour, extremely sour. Okay, its meaning is given over there. Brahmarantra, that meaning is given over there at the bottom of the page you see. In Kannada, the soft part in a child's head where skull bones join later. So that is called Brahmarantra. Here used as an idiomatic expression to convey the extreme potency of sourness. मैंने बोल दिया Brahmarantra यानी extremely sour. I once took one such fruit home and a chutney was made out of it. All of us ate it. The cough we suffered from after that. It was when I went for the cough medicine that the doctor told me about the special quality of the fruit. उसके बाद दवाई लेने गया, तब डॉक्टर ने बताया कि ये मैंगो की चटनी थोड़ी खा सकते हैं यार, इतनी खट्टी होती है, ये तो उसकी क्वालिटी है. ओके, जस्ट एज द मैंगो इज स्पेशल, सो इज एवरीथिंग एल्स अराउंड आवर विलेज. वी हैव अ क्रीपर ग्रोइंग इन द एवर सो फाइन वाटर ऑफ द विलेज पॉन्ड. ओके, इट्स फ्लावर्स आर अ फीस्ट टू बिहोल्ड, इट्स फ्लावर्स आर अ जॉय टू बिहोल्ड. Get two leaves from the creeper when you go to the pond for your bath. Now he gives us something about this creeper. कि इसके flowers तो beautiful है ही, उसको देख के किसी को भी joy मिलेगा. But when you go to take your bath in that pond, what you do? You take two leaves with you of that creeper. Two leaves you take, so you don't have to worry about where to serve the food. In which thing to serve the food, you can serve the food in those leaves, because that is normal tradition in most of the South Indian states. They will serve you food in leaves, big leaves. Okay, so that's what he is telling us over here. And you will not have to worry about not having leaves on which to serve the afternoon meal. Understood? You will say I am rambling. Okay, you will say that I am confused. Main ranga ki baat kar raha hun ki ye kaun si baat kar raha hun. Okay, I am diverting, you might say. It is always like that when the subject of our village comes up. तो बोले जब हमारे गांव की बात होती है तो मैं डिस्ट्रैक्ट हो ही जाता हूँ, बराबर. वो जो पॉइंट चल रहा है वो छोड़ के मैं गांव की बातें करने लग जाता हूँ. सो दैट इज द वीकनेस ऑफ द नरेटर. बट इनफ, इफ एनी वन ऑफ यू वुड लाइक टू विजिट अस, ड्रॉप मी अ लाइन. ड्रॉप मी अ लाइन मीन्स राइट टू मी, किसी को भी विजिट करना है तो आई विल लेट यू नो वेयर होसाली इज एंड व्हाट थिंग्स आर लाइक हियर, बताऊंगा ये कहाँ आया है, तुम वहाँ कैसे पहुँच सकते हो और यहाँ क्या क्या है. ओके, द बेस्ट वे ऑफ गेटिंग टू नो अ प्लेस इज टू विजिट इट, डोंट यू अग्री? सो ही इज राइट इन दैट यू माइट गेट मैनी इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट अ प्लेस थ्रू वीडियोज एंड थ्रू दिस वन सोशल मीडिया, बट द बेस्ट वे टू नो अबाउट अ प्लेस इज टू गो देर एंड विजिट इट, देन ओनली यू विल कम टू नो. अंडरस्टूड? वॉट आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू इज समथिंग दैट हैपन 10 years अगो. We did not have many people who knew English. Now he talks about the status of English. What was the status of English? 10 years ago, he says that no one knew English 10 years ago. Okay? Not a single English word you would find them using in their own language. Okay? So students, South Indian states and the people are very much language conscious. Okay? Even now also students, you may find them just giving a lot of priority to their language. If you speak ill of their language, they will get angry. They will run after you to hit you. कि हमारी language के बारे में ऐसा नहीं बोलने का. Okay? Many of them have even today not accepted Hindi as our national language. So they give importance only to their mother tongue, their own language. अंडरस्टूड? सो दैट्स वाई ही इज टॉकिंग ओवर हीयर कि इंग्लिश की हमारे यहाँ कोई वैल्यू ही नहीं थी. 10 साल पहले कोई इंग्लिश बोलता ही नहीं था. इंग्लिश बोलता तो नहीं था पर इंग्लिश वर्ड्स भी नहीं बोलते थे लोकल लैंग्वेज में. ओके, वी डिड नॉट हैव मैनी पीपल हु न्यू इंग्लिश देन. और विलेज अकाउंटेंट वॉज द फर्स्ट वन हु हैड इनफ करेज टू सेंड हिज सन टू बेंगलोर टू स्टडी. इट इज़ डिफरेंट नाउ. अभी 10 साल के बाद ये प्लेस डिफरेंट हो गया है. बराबर? देर आर मैनी हु नो इंग्लिश. During the holidays, you come across them on every street talking in English. आजकल देखो तो holidays पे काफ़ी सारे लोग street पे खड़े हुए English में बातें करते हुए मिलेंगे. But 10 years ago, it was not so. Understood? Those days, we did not speak in English. Nor did we bring in English words while talking in Kannada. So that's what. Not a single word in their own language. Okay? Kannada में बात करते हुए English का word भी तब नहीं बोलते थे 10 साल पहले. What has happened is disgraceful. So here the writer narrator gives his own opinion. Okay, I already mentioned the narrator also considered it disgraceful. What is disgraceful? People speaking English language. That according to narrator also is disgraceful. Why should you forget your own language and start speaking other language? That is his view. Okay, believe me, The other day, I was in Rama Rao's house when they bought a bundle of firewood. बराबर? उन्होंने Rama Rao के घर पे ये था. Rama Rao is another character in the village, and the narrator was at his house. And that time, they purchased what? A bundle of firewood. Rama Rao's son came out to pay for it. He asked the woman, "How much should I give you?" 4 pais, she said. 4 pais, the currency of that time. Ki 4 paise, 4 pais. The boy told her he did not have any change and asked her to come the next morning. Wo lady ko bola, theek hai, tum kal aana, aaj change nahi hai. Now, when we speak now, change, all of you understand. Change, yani chhutte nahi. But that lady was wondering, change ka matlab kya? Even the narrator was wondering. Narrator also did not know the meaning of change at that time. Okay? So, the poor woman did not understand the English word change and went away muttering to herself. I too did not know. See, narrator also accepts that he also did not know the meaning of change. Later, when I went to Ranga's house and asked him, I understood what it meant. Understood? So, afterwards, narrator only asked at Ranga's house, what is the meaning of change? Then he also came to know. So you, from this situation, you can imagine what was the condition of English at that time. Understood? So this question is normally asked to students. Ki describe what is Hosali famous for? So those two reasons. And what was the status of English 10 years ago in this particular village Hosali? So all these details you'll have to give in that answer. Okay? So students, afterwards, now onwards, the lesson will talk about only and only about Ranga's marriage. This all things he have talked just to start the lesson background. First, he has described the place, how was the place. Then he has described the status of English. But now onwards, we will see only how Ranga's marriage takes place and who is the main schemer in that. Who arranges marriage of Ranga with Ratna. All those things, students, we will see in my next video. Till that time, stay fit, stay fine. Read this lesson. It is really an interesting lesson. God bless you.